হ্যালো স্যার, স্যার বলছি সাউন্ডটা শোনা যাচ্ছে না স্যার।
আপনার কেটে কেটে যাচ্ছে
স্যার, কথাটা একটু কেটে কেটে যাচ্ছে।
দেখ আমাকে দেখি
এখন কেটে কেটে যাচ্ছে স্যার কথাটা অ্যাকচুয়ালি।
Is it audible now?
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now it is audible. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is audible.
So we will start a particular type of break now, that is block break with short shoe. Now this is the type of the break. You see, this one is the break drum and this is the shoe, break shoe. So this is the block, this one is the block, over it there is break shoe, and this block is mounted on a lever, and this is the fulcrum point, and this is the handle, and the force is applied here. Now these dimensions are very important. That is, this is one dimension, this is another dimension. You just look at the dimensions, and this is another dimension. So these three dimensions are very important. Another important thing is direction of rotation. So
sir, the screen the present name most probably.
Screen the present name. Let's see. Can you see? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, this is the block break with short shoe. Now, this one is the break drum. Okay. This is the lever arm by which the force is applied, brake is applied, or brake is disconnected. There is a block here, this one is the block, and there is a shoe, that is the friction material. This one is the friction material, and this is pressed on the brake drum. Now there are some dimensions which are very important. That is this dimension. This dimension, dimension A, dimension B, and dimension C. These three dimensions are very important. Another important thing is the direction of rotation. Now, the entire thing, you will understand later that for this configuration, that is fulcrum this end, the point of application of force is P, and it is rotating is clockwise direction. So this is one configuration. Now this theta is important. This theta, that is the included angle of the brake shoe. When it is less than 45 degree, then it is called short shoe. When it is higher than 45 degree, that is included angle, that is higher than 45 degree, then it is called long shoe. So we are discussing here block brake, that is this is the block, that is the shoe, and with short shoe means that depends on the included angle. And it is designed or the analysis is done for the clockwise direction. Now the block is rigidly fixed here. Okay, that is very important thing. The block is rigidly fixed here, and friction material is rigidly attached to the block, and this can be placed onto the surface of the drum. That is a cylindrical element. Now, the friction causes retardation of the drum. Obviously, this type of brake is used in railway cars. Now, there are some assumptions. The assumptions are on which the analysis is done. The block is rigidly fixed over the lever. Angle of contact is small so that it can be defined as short shoe, and direction of rotation is clockwise. So with these assumptions, the analysis is done. So this slide is okay or not? Whatever I have discussed so far, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, the same figure in a free body diagram form. Okay, so this is the direction of rotation. So this will be the direction of mu n, this is n, and this is the direction of mu n, this is n, and these are the dimensions, and this is rx and ry. Now, considering the forces acting on the brake and drum. So, brake and drum, the forces are like this, mu n, n and p, rx and ry, these are the forces. So, the mt will be mu n multiplied by r. This mu n multiplied by r, that is the radius of the brake drum. So these terms have the usual meanings. Now n will be equal to the normal force. The normal force will be equal to PLW. P is permissible pressure on the friction material. L is length of the block, the length of the block, and W is width of block. So this is n. This is the expression of n. Now, the width and length, these are conflicting effect. These have conflicting effect. That means if one increases, other will decrease. That means if W is small, L will increase, and if L increase, then size of the brake will be large, and that cannot be defined as short shoe. So we are considering it, we are analyzing it on the basis of short shoe. So W and L, since they have conflicting effect on the definition of the block break, so there is an optimum value of W. And this optimum value is this. That means W should be greater than 1/4 drum dia and less than half of drum dia. So this is the limit of W. So based on this limiting value of the W, that means this limiting value is used to satisfy that the break is defined as short screw. So this is the limiting value of W. Is it clear up to this for this slide? This side is clear. Hello, anyone respond?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Now, so the same diagram for the sake of analysis. So the same diagram for the sake of analysis. Now, considering equilibrium of forces, so obviously Rx will be equal to V1 and Ry equal to N minus P. Very simple equation. So taking moment of forces about the hinge, the equation will be P multiplied by V minus N multiplied by this A plus mu n multiplied by C. This is the C, mu n multiplied by C, and from this we can write that A is equal to P is equal to A minus mu C by B multiplied by N. Now this expression is very important. How? Now here P is the actuating force. This is the P, that is the actuating force, and that is applied by the user. Now from this equation three situation arises. So P is equal to A minus mu C divided by B multiplied by N. Three situation arises. The first situation is when A is greater than mu C. A is greater than mu C. Now when A greater than mu C, what will happen? A greater than mu C means the friction force mu n reduces the actuating force. So friction force mu n reduces the actuating force. That is, so moment due to P multiplied by B and moment due to mu n multiplied by C, that is, this is the moment, this moment, since they are both in CCW, so this friction force, the moment due to friction force is added to the moment due to the effort. Okay, so that is why it is called self-energizing. That means friction force is being generated and this friction force is added to the moment due to the effort. Okay, so this way it is self-energizing. That means some moment is being generated from the system. In this way it is called self-energizing, and it is not self-locking. Self-locking, why it is not self-locking? That means some amount of force is to be applied for breaking. So you have to apply some force. If you need not apply some force, if the situation is such that you need not apply some force, that is not a desirable situation. So desirable situation should be you have to apply some force, and also that force is being reduced due to the mu multiplied by n. So due to mu n, mu multiplied by n, the P is being reduced. But still, when this condition is satisfied, that is A greater than mu C, then this break is under control because you have to apply some force. So, and this is the most desirable case, that is when the situation is for self-energizing and not self-locking. Now consider the another case, when A is equal to mu C. So if dimension is such, A and C dimension is such that A equal to mu C, then P will be zero. And obviously P is zero, so there no breaking action is required. So this becomes out of control of the user, out of control of the operator. And this is obviously is not a desirable situation. So when A is equal to mu C, P becomes zero, and this is not a desirable situation. Is it clear? This is not a desirable situation. Is it clear? These two conditions are clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then we will go for the third condition, when A is less than mu C. So A is less than mu C means P becomes negative. And this is a dangerous operating condition. The break becomes uncontrollable as the operator cannot apply it. So operator cannot apply it and break becomes uncontrollable. So this situation should never occur. And the desirable situation is A greater than mu C. So this is the desirable situation and self-energizing situation. So how it is self-energizing, is it clear to you? Hello, is it clear,
yes, sir,
how it is self-energizing? And so this situation is desirable. Now the normal reaction N. So you look at the figure. So normal reaction is N. So this normal reaction is applied from one side. So there is a chance of deformation, or there is a chance of deformation of the shaft. So if the block is from both sides, obviously this end and that end will just cancel each other. So we can use block breaks with short screw on both sides of the ramp. Okay, so block break with short screw on both sides of the drum. Okay, so normal reaxial N can N on break drum may cause some deflection of the shaft of break drum. Therefore, in actual practice, two symmetrical block break screws are used on both sides of the drum. Now, the another situation, that means we have started with that it is rotating on this side, that is clockwise direction. Now the brake can rotate, the drum can rotate on the opposite direction, so CCW direction. Now for this, when it is in CCW direction, then what will be the equations? You look at the equation is P multiplied by B minus N multiplied by A minus mu N multiplied by C. And from this, P is equal to A plus mu C by B multiplied by N. And in the earlier equation, it was A minus mu C. Now it is A plus mu C divided by B multiplied by N. So this is the expression. So the minus sign is changed to plus sign. So breaking force P is more for CCW. Obviously, the breaking force, so for this configuration, when the first term, when the fulcrum is on this side, when the falcum on this side, then rotation in CCW direction would require the higher amount of braking force, higher amount of effort, because it is plus. Okay, but for the same configuration, you just change the position of the lever. That means if this falcum is on that side and P is on that side, then this figure will give you the self-energizing effect. So now the total brake effort depends on obviously this brake effort, whether it is plus or minus. The total brake effort depends on A, C, mu and direction of rotation. So direction of rotation is very important. So this P depends on A, C, mu and the direction of rotation. So on the basis of direction of rotation and on the basis of the configuration, the P will, in the expression of P, there will be either plus or either minus, and if it is minus, that is very desirable thing. Is it clear up to this?
Yes sir.
Okay. So block brake with short shoe. Now if we use double block brake, that means block from both sides. Yeah, block from both sides. So R for right, this R for right and this L for left. That means there are shoes on both sides and these are the fulcrum. Clear? Now the force is applied in this manner. Okay, the same thing, the same figure, only there are two shoes. Now this overcomes the disadvantage of a single block brake, obviously. Now taking moments about pivot D. Now look at the dimensions. So from here to here, this dimension is C. Similarly, from here to here, this dimension is C. Okay. And this dimension is BB. This is B and this is B. So this dimension is BB and there is theta theta. Okay. So this is the thing. Now taking moments about pivot D. So NR multiplied by B, NR multiplied by B plus mu NR multiplied by C, this C. Mu NR multiplied by C equal to twice BP.
So
twice B multiplied by P. So from this, NR is equal to 2BP divided by B plus mu C. This is the value of NR. Now taking moments about C. That is this point. Taking moment about this C, then NL multiplied by B. NL multiplied by B equal to mu NL multiplied by C plus twice BP. And from this, NL is equal to twice BP divided by B minus mu C. So NR is equal to twice BP divided by B plus mu C and NL equal to twice BP divided by B minus mu C. So torque capacity of brake. What will be the torque capacity of the brake? The torque capacity of brake will be obviously MT is equal to mu NL plus NR multiplied by R. Obviously, this is the expression for MT. So R is the radius of the breakdown. So this is the value of MT. So we have to find out NL and NR, then we can find out MT. So is it okay? This slide.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, long shoe. So, long shoe means the included angle, subtended angle will be higher and higher than 45 degree. Okay. So, this is the subtended angle. Subtended angle will be higher than 45 degree. So, this is the break, the drum. Now, let us start analyze the situation. So, it is block break with long shoe. Now, we have considered some elemental area on the in the exaggerated form on the friction surface, friction material. So, this is dn, this is r d phi, the length, and this is dn, this is mu dn, because it is rotating in this direction. So, forces on friction lining. And this is forces on brake drum. Now look at the forces on the brake drum. So this will be dn, this will be mu dn because it is rotating in this direction, and this angle is d phi. Now normal reaction on elemental friction line. So we have considered an elemental friction lining and normal reaction on the elemental friction lining, that is dn. So dn is equal to r d phi w multiplied by p. So this is the dn. So w is width of friction lining, p equal to pressure intensity on the element. Now frictional torque. What is frictional torque? Frictional torque will be equal to on the elemental friction lining. So del mt equal to mu pi dn. So mu dn into r. So this is the torque. So putting this value, we are getting mu equal to r square d phi w p. So mt will be equal to, you just integrate it over this e d phi, and the rest are the standard one, sorry, constant one. So this is the expression for mt. Now to evaluate the integration, the integration is this. Now we will try to evaluate the integration. So this slide is clear up to the expression of integration?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now to evaluate the integration, to exaggerate kore aka hoyeche the friction lining and the wear in the exaggerated form. Now you see, this is the friction lining and this is wear in exaggerated form. Wear in exaggerated form means this point is y dash, it will come to y. After friction, there is wear. After this wear, this white part will be worn out. So due to this wear, this y dash will come to y. This is the point. This is the significance of this figure. So y dash will come to y. The block of lining will retain its cylindrical shape. So due to there will be radial wear. Due to radial wear, point y dash moves to y under the force p. So del y and del r are wear in y and radial direction respectively. So del y and del r. So this is del y and this is del r. So wear in radial direction, wear in y direction. Okay. So del r is proportional to frictional work. That is the wear. So del r is proportional to frictional work. Now from this expression, from this configuration, del y equal to del r divided by cos phi. okay, and that is equal to constant. So this is equal to constant means del r proportional to mu dn. That is del r proportional to mu r d phi from the earlier side, mu r d phi w into p. And from this, we can write del r proportional to p, because others are constant, del r proportional to p. And when you can write del r proportional to p, from this expression, we can write p. We can write that p by cos phi equal to constant, because del r proportional to p, so p by cos phi equal to constant. Clear up to this,
sir? In the left figure, you told that the y dash comes to y. That point I didn't understood.
So because there is radial wear, because the shape will remain cylindrical. So if shape remains cylindrical, then what will happen? This is the wear. So this is the, if this is the wear, then due to wear, this surface will come to this surface, okay, due to the wear. So if this surface come to this surface, then y dash will come to y. This is the point y. Y dash will come to y. Clear?
Sir, the friction lining will be on.
Friction lining will be on now.
Mm-hmm.
So this white part will be on now. Okay. This white part will be on now, and this one remain cylindrical, this internal surface remain cylindrical, then y dash will come to y. Clear? This is the exaggerated form. Y dash will come to y, and this is del y.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. When the brake is applied, then the y dash will come to y. Okay, okay.
Exactly.
Okay, sir.
Yes, brake is in contact. Clear?
Okay, sir. Clear, sir. Please continue.
And these equations are clear? Ultimately,
yes,
p by cos phi equal to constant. Clear?
Yes,
now, p by cos phi equal to constant. So, p is equal to c1 cos phi. That is constant. So, p is equal to p max cos phi. When c1 is p max, c1 is written as p max, because for phi is equal to 0, p will be equal to c1. For phi is equal to 0, p will be equal to c1, and that is written as p max. So the expression becomes p equal to p max cos phi when p max is equal to c1. So dn, that is the normal force. Normal force, this dn. This dn, I am showing you this dn, okay? So dn is equal to r d phi w, this is the area, multiplied by p max cos phi. Multiplied by p means p max cos phi. Okay, so this is dn. So horizontal component of forces on two sides of lining will balance. So only vertical forces will remain. So from this, n is equal to integration dn cos phi. So put the expression, this expression, so it will be cos square phi. So from this, this is the expression. N is the vertical force. So you have to integrate from minus theta to plus theta on both sides. From minus theta to plus theta. And the integration is this. Okay. Integration is this. So mt is equal to. Acha, it's like a purishkar holo. Up to this, is it clear?
Sir, from minus theta to plus theta, could you please explain?
দুদিকে আছে তো তো ফিগারটা দেখো
স্যার ফ্রম দা লেফট সাইড অফ দা ফ্রিকশন লাইন টু দা ওকে
ওকে ফ্রম দিস সাইড টু দ্যাট সাইড ফ্রম দিস সাইড টু দ্যাট সাইড
ওকে ওকে স্যার
ওকে ফ্রম মাইনাস থিটা টু থিটা দ্যাট মিন্স ইউ আর ইন্টিগ্রেটিং ফর দি এক্স ইনক্লুডেড অ্যাঙ্গেল টু থিটা ক্লিয়ার
ওকে স্যার
ইউ হ্যাভ টু ইন্টিগ্রেট ওভার টু থিটা ওকে
ওকে স্যার
Clear? So n is equal to this. N is equal to this. Now we are finding out the expression for mt. Again, we integrate from minus theta to plus theta. So this is the expression for mt. Now mt divided by n. So there is an expression for mt and there is an expression for n, and ultimately it will take the shape that is mu r into 4 sin theta by 2 theta sin theta. That means mu n r 4 sin theta divided by 2 theta sin 2 theta. Okay. So friction force will be mt divided by r. Do you accept this? Friction force will be, that means mt is friction force multiplied by r. So if you divide it by r, then this will be the friction force. Okay, so from this is the friction force. So if this is friction force, then friction force is normal force multiplied by mu. So there is an equivalent mu, that is mu dash equal to mu multiplied by this. Mu multiplied by this, this is the equivalent frictional coefficient. So it is similar to the expression of block break with short shoe while mu replacing by mu dash. If you replace mu by mu dash, then it is the similar expression of block break with long shoe. Is it clear?
Yes.
It's clear?
So sir, what advantage do we get from the short shoe to the long shoe? The more friction force is applied or something else?
That means you are getting mu dust. You are getting mu dust instead of in place of mu. Clear?
Yes.
So if mu dust is higher than mu, what will be the advantage?
Then the friction force will increase.
Friction force will increase, and friction force is responsible for applying the breaking force.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Continue. Please.
Using the same material, you are getting, using the same friction material, you are getting higher mu. Okay, because there is an expression for equivalent mu.
Okay, sir.
Clear. Okay. Now band break. Band break. So there is a break drum. There is a break drum. And there is a flexible steel plate. Flexible steel strip lined with friction material. So it is a steel strip lined with friction material so that there is friction in between the steel strip and the breakdown. Clear? Now, this is the P, this is the lever arm, this is P2, and this P1, the direction of applying force passes through the fulcrum. So when band passes through the pivot, it is called simple band break. And there is another case when this P1 not passing through this pivot, then it is not simple. Okay, so it is simple. So what will be that? That will be discussed later. So band break, that is simple. Simple band break means when the P1 passes through this. Okay. Now one thing, it will be discussed in your belt and pulley, and you have already studied belt and pulley dive in your kinematics class, is it? In your kinematics class, belt pulley dive you have studied. Kinematics of machine class, I am asking you.
No, sir.
Huh? No, sir.
No, sir. Kinematics of Hoini, sir.
Kinematics of machine to other Hoini?
Kinematics of machine, so it's a sir, kintu mane shesh mane egulo kichu hoyni ar ki.
না স্যার, এই টেনশন গুলো মনে হয়নি। T1 T2 সে থাকে না, কি T2 বাই T1 ইকুয়ালস টু
ইটু দি পাওয়ার মি। হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ, P1 বাই P2 ইকুয়াল টু ইটু দি পাওয়ার মি থিটা করা পড়েছে না
কোনো? না কিন্তু স্যার ওগুলো আমাদের হয়নি, মানে কাইনেমেটিক সিনথেসিস
হতো স্যার। ওটা কাইনেমেটিক্স এ হয়নি, ওটা সে ফার্স্ট ইয়ার স্ট্যাটিক্স এর সাথে একটু ছিল, এখানে
হয়নি। P1 বাই P2 ইকুয়াল টু ইটু দি পাওয়ার মি থিটা কোথাও হয়েছে? ব্ল্যাকবোর্ড থাকলে বুঝিয়ে দেওয়া যেত কিছুটা মুশকিল কাণ্ড। দেখো, সো দিস ইজ দ্য ড্রাম, দিস ইজ দ্য ড্রাম, দিস ইজ পি ওয়ান, দিস ইজ পি টু, অ্যান্ড দিস ইজ অ্যাপ্লাইড। What I was telling that for belt and pulley, it is like belt and pulley. For a belt and pulley, have you seen anywhere belt and pulley dive? You have seen belt and pulley dive in your workshop?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Belt pulley dive in workshop class, you have seen? So
yes,
in belt pulley dive, you just imagine. So there is a larger pulley and there is a smaller pulley, clear? And a belt wraps over the two pulleys, clear? So there is a driver pulley and there is a driven pulley. Suppose the smaller pulley is the driver pulley and larger pulley is the driven pulley. Can you imagine the thing? So, and you imagine the thing, that is, it is the smaller pulley is rotating in the clockwise direction. Can you imagine the figure now? So there is a smaller pulley, there is a larger pulley and connected by a belt. Very simple thing, you can imagine this. Okay, now say the smaller pulley is rotating in clockwise direction. So the right hand side of the pulley will be in the higher tension, and the left hand side of the right hand side of the belt will be in the higher tension, and left hand side of the belt will be in the lower section. That is, right hand side is called tight side and left hand side is called slack side, SLACK, slack side. Is it clear what I have told? Now, can you imagine this thing? Just a minute. Okay, is it possible to present two screen simultaneously? I like to show you a paint a bitmap. Is it possible to show two things simultaneously? Is it possible? Do you know it? If I like to show you another screen, is it possible?
Yes, sir. Then you can divide the screen into two halves, like.
Okay, forget it. I don't know whether it is possible or not. If the connection is lost, then it will be a problem. So what I was telling, that for belt and pulley, if this is the direction of rotation, you can see the screen. You are seeing the screen. So for belt and pulley, this is P2 and this is P1. If the direction of rotation is this, then P2 will be greater than P1. If the direction of rotation is this. But in this case, when it is brake, and if this is the direction of rotation, then P1 will be greater than P2. You can easily understand this. If P1 is not greater than P2, you cannot stop the drum by applying this band brake. Do you accept my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, unlike your belt and pulley, for belt and pulley, if this is the case for belt and pulley, then P2 must be greater than P1. Otherwise, it cannot rotate in this direction. So, P2 is greater than P1. But since it is brake, my point is, P1 is greater than P2. This is my point. Very simple point I was telling you. Okay. Now, see the configuration. So, this is the application of force and this is the dimension. Now, this is P2 and there is another dimension like small a. Okay. And this is R. So, these two dimensions are important, L and A. Okay. And P1 passing through the center of the fulcrum, center of the pivot. Okay. Now, for belt and pulley dive, it works like a belt and pulley dive with zero velocity because it is top. It works like a belt and pulley dive with zero velocity. And P1 by P2 equal to e to the power mu theta. For belt and pulley, it would have been P2 by P1 equal to e to the power mu theta, but since it is belt, since it is brake, it will be P1 by P2 equal to e to the power mu theta. P1 and P2 are tensions on the tight and loose side of the band. Mu and theta are coefficient of friction and angle of wrap. Angle of wrap means, this is the angle of wrap, that means the angle through which it is in contact. This is called angle of wrap. So P on by PT is e to the power mu theta. Here theta is called the angle of wrap. This angle of wrap is important. So torque will be equal to P1 minus P2 multiplied by R, obviously. Torque will be equal to P1 minus P2 multiplied by R. So moments about pivot, P2 multiplied by A equal to P multiplied by L. And this P1 is not here because it is passing through the fulcrum. So P2 multiplied by A equal to P multiplied by L. So P is equal to P2 A by L. P is equal to. Now element of friction lining, elemental friction lining. So considering this elemental friction lining, you see this is dn, this is r d phi, this is d phi, this side is under higher tension p plus dp, this side is on the lower tension, this is p. And this angle is d phi by 2, obviously. This angle is d phi by 2. So, this is the description, subtending angle d phi, width of w, elemental area r d phi w, pressure intensity is small p. So, dn will be equal to this. Is dn. Dn will be equal to prw d phi. R d phi w is the area multiplied by p. That is the pressure intensity. So dn is equal to p sin this dn. From this expression dn. Dn is equal to, that is, this is dn, this is p, this is p plus. So from this dn is equal to this thing, p sin d phi by 2 plus p plus dp sin d phi by 2. So this is p d phi, okay, it is small angle. So dn is equal to p d phi. So from this, when p is maximum, p is maximum means it is equal to p1. So p max is will be equal to rw. Is it clear from up to this slide? Is it clear?
Sir, could you please explain?
Which one is not clear?
Sir, for the steel strip, why the left side will be tight side and the upside will be slack one?
Left.
Sir, you explain that here the P1 is the tight side and P2 is the slack side, and actually when the drum is rotating clockwise, the P2 should be tight side and P1 should be slack side, but here we are taking as P1 by P2 equals to P to the power mu theta. That means P1 is the tight side and P2 is the slack side. And I'm asking that why P1 is the tight side and P2 is the slack side here.
Hello, Shivnath. Shivnath.